structure in the way I saw him was something that I will never forget.
Daniel Afori Minta explains the shock and the hurt the day he was sent to the hospital to say goodbye to his 14-year-old son, Malvrick Donker.
He's a respectful, a loving guy, a very intelligent guy, somebody I can never forget, somebody the mother can never forget.
The 14-year-old freshman moved here from Ghana just 8 months ago to be with his mother. He was excited to become a better swimmer. At the end of last week's class, police say a student found him underwater.
And so I wanted to know from the school what really happened, not from the media.
The father and his legal advisor, Carlton Hume, are talking about an article they read stating a source watched the surveillance video from Manchester High School's pool showing the teen underwater in the deep end for about 17 minutes.
Until a full investigation has been done, and we also intend to do our own down the road as well, but until that's done, we're withholding a judgment.
But they are commenting on how changes must be made immediately.
No child should have to drown. And that's why I'm thinking that whatever the method out there that they're using to have pool classes or physical education classes, it doesn't work.
Middletown Public Schools tell News 8 they're already reviewing their procedures. Less than a year ago, an East Hartford student also drowned at a school.
Swimming, I know swimming is the most hardest exercise one can have.
The father says the school is helping them find a spot to have the memorial service so that all students can say goodbye properly. We will, of course, keep you up to date on this. We do know that the father wants to have that service on Saturday, December 15th. In Hartford, Aaron Logan, News 8.